The race to finish the census is coming to an end, and believe it or not, Alabama is in dead last. But if the census has slipped your mind, you still have some time left. Our Sydney Stallworth tells us why Huntsville City officials are urging you to fill it out.
Taking a few minutes to fill out some information that could impact the state for decades to come. Alabama is ranked last in census response rates nationally, but Huntsville City officials say we have the chance right here in the valley to make a difference now.
We are forecasted to lose one of our congressional seats. It's not a done possibility. So if we get enough people counted in the state of Alabama, we could keep our congressional seat.
Census responses could have a big impact for folks in Huntsville too, as the city grows.
You know, we are a big, important federal town. So a lot of federal dollars come through here. So it's very important for Huntsville's economy that we have this delegation.
And it's all hands on deck to get the last responses in. James Vandiver says community partners are reaching out.
They're knocking on doors. They're putting up yards. Signs. They are, calling people, texting people, emailing people.
Census takers are already going door to door to reach people who haven't been counted. The deadline to respond is September 30th. We're told you can even mail in your response on the 30th and still be counted.
Do this anywhere, at any time, on your phone, on a tablet, or any kind of device. Like I said, you can call if smartphones aren't your thing. You can call the Census Bureau, 844-330-2020. But also, you know, it's really convenient. All you need is your address, really.
Because Huntsville is expected to become the highest populated city in the state in just a few years, census responses this year are absolutely crucial. And city officials are begging you, just pull out your phone and fill it out. It shouldn't take more than 10 minutes. And if you're single and you live alone, it should actually take a little bit less than that. Putting the Valley first, Sydney Stallworth, WZDX News.